Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about Nest.js and MongoDB, how to connect to MongoDB and how to write the schema models, all these different aspects, and we will create a REST APIs where we will have a get, put, post, delete. We will be updating, deleting, creating data in MongoDB. Okay, so for that what we need to do is we need to have a Node.js server up and running. First, we will do the local installation of required modules in the Nest.js package. Okay, so here is our project. I just created another branch to work on it. Now, we just need to install some required package, which I can do. So here it is, Nest.js Mongoose. And one is Mongoose module. So these two modules which we need, I'm just installing them. After that, once they have installed, we can actually create a database module where we will just talk about Nest.js installation, initializing the MongoDB connection. database.module.ts we can have. Right, this module will be same as what we have created in the task module. Only now we will do different things here. Only things which are related to database. We don't have controllers and services. Okay, now what we will do is we will create one. So this is database module. We just do the cleanup first. Okay. Now, we will also look at the documentation. Before that, what we need to do? We have installed Nest.js Mongoose and Mongoose module. Now, to actually create our module, we just need to initialize the database connection. Okay. So we just need to import Nest.js Mongoose from the library which we just installed. This is Mongoose module, and in the import declaration we can just pass the database configuration. In the import, what we will do is we will just say Mongoose module dot for root, and there are different ways of doing it. Currently we are hard coding the API URL, so it will have the URL of your database connection. That's it, and we are exporting this module. Right now, this module we can use as a shared module, and this can be injected on the other modules which we are going to build, and we can access the schemas from this MongoDB module. So the URL would be like this, which we have MongoDB colon, here it is your localhost colon, the port 27017, I think. This is used to be the MongoDB port and your database, and here you can pass the argument is the parser, otherwise you will get a warning. So you can just write use new URL parser. This is the argument which you need to pass while creating connection. Right, so now this Mongoose module can be a part of your app module, and you can start creating the schemas. So MongoDB module is a NoSQL database. There we are creating collections and we are inserting, updating, deleting the documents, right? So what we will do, we will write a customer APIs, create, update, delete, customer list APIs, okay? And like, let's say we can create a customer module here. Customer module will have its controller, services and all the things. Like same as we have a DTOs, schema will be a customer schema. So how we create a, first of all, schema for database, like in MySQL we create a tables, right? And then we are creating type ORM entities in Nest.js. Similarly, we are not talking about MySQL here, basic MongoDB. So here we are managing the connection. It will take care of all the things, connecting to database and checking if this particular host is available or not, otherwise you will not be able to start the application. You don't need to manage the connection on error, on success, what need to be done. Okay, here we have customer module. Here we will create our schema. And in the schemas, you can just say customer schema.ts, right? So here we will define our schema. Customer has a first name, last name and all. And we are going to define the schema same as we were doing in the Express or basic Node.js application. Okay, we are importing Mongoose and we can just simply say that I have created customer schema and then I'm exporting it. Right, these are the attributes I'm having this customer schema. Now, my REST APIs, whatever I'm going to build, I will be just using this customer schema table. It's actually a model I have created and I will be injecting this schema on the different modules where I'm going to use or access the data. Okay, here like I have a customer module. So here I will have a controllers also. I will also create services and customer.module.ts. Right, so in the customer.module.ts, it is a same kind of module which we have in the task module. So I will just copy things from there. Later we will create the customer controller, customer services and all. Here it is, customer module. So this video also talks about how we are isolating the modules. First I created a database module which is just dealing with the database connection. Okay, now this database module can be a part of our app module. Here I will just import this database module in the app module. You just import it, right? Now I have a customer module. So customer module, I will just, now this database module is globally available. Now you can access the database module in the customer module. So in the next video, we will write customer controller and customer service.